our way into the story, and what's sort of based on the fact that there are people who answer these letters to Verona, was this idea that a letter was written and never got opened. It gets, you know, stuck in the wall there, and 50 years later, not only does it get opened, it gets answered. And the person who wrote it when she was a little girl, well, when she was a 16-year-old, now gets it 50 years later, and comes back to actually find the man that she was in love with 50 years ago.
And it was such a pure-hearted idea that people from all over the world, from all different cultures, from men, women, young people, old people. There was even a soldier in Iraq who wrote, "Dear Juliet, please pray for me." And we thought, gosh, that's so, in a world, in the cynical world we live in, it's just the most pure-hearted idea that you would reach out, even though it's to a fictional suicide, you would reach out to somebody who represents the purity of love.
It's a movie of destiny. It's a movie of many destinies. And I think that's part of what you're, again, going to get that you don't get in obvious movies. Movies that you're moved in so many directions, but you can relate to. And I think that young women and young men and people of all ages are going to, with the child inside themselves, so to speak, find a connection to these characters.
Sophie's a really smart girl, and she's young. But she's out of college and she's working for the New Yorker, which is so, it's so lucky. And she, you know, strives to be this journalist. And I think that she will one day be a young, successful journalist. But right now she's a fact checker when the story takes place. And she's on this trip with her fiance, and she's writing. She's writing a story, hoping that her editor will publish it.
He's basically a very specific person that loves more food than anything else, and he loves the connection that he has with food, and he wants to share this with other people, and especially with his girlfriend.
I guess Charlie, you could say, is the antagonist of our story. He's kind of the negative voice in the first part of the film that sort of reluctantly goes on this journey with his grandmother to find her long-lost lover that she wrote this letter to when she was 15 years of age. So, but you know, along the journey he sort of opens up and sort of unwinds and becomes less of a sort of, you know, British prig and learns that love is real. And,
you know, I mean, modestly speaking, I think I'm creating a masterpiece. I don't know. I mean, there's one that just came out perfect right now, which is, you know, I think it's this one. I think it's this. Try it.
Can I just say something?
What?
We're leaving in 12 hours, and you haven't packed for Verona.
Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Victor and Sophie are not sharing the same moment together. You know, I mean, they can't share it for many reasons. I mean, normally in any other. I mean, in any other circumstance, Sophie could enjoy what Victor's journey is all about, you know, and they could share it and they could be accomplices of each other, but they're actually not enjoying this moment together.
She's realizing that there's much more, that you can have much more in a relationship, and that Charlie truly loves her or is becoming, you know, quite appreciative of her existence, and she's appreciating him in ways that she's never been appreciated by Victor.
So that's when Sophie starts to discovers the secretaries and these people who write the letters to Juliet, and they ask her to join in.
All right, that's enough.
Sophie.
That's enough.
Your writing is really good.
Thank you.
No, it's really, really, really good.
Why are you so surprised?
How come you've never shown your work to anyone?
I never feel like it's finished.
Why?
Because I guess I'm a perfectionist.
You know, that's just another way of saying I'm a chicken. Listen, you've got nothing to be afraid of. You're not a fact checker, you're a writer. What was that for?
I'm not a chicken.